Cheetah, we're heading into the peak of hurricane season, and we already have a lot of activity in the tropics.
You're right about that. September the 10th is actually the official date of the peak of hurricane season, but it is ramping up right now, as expected. Two waves in the open Atlantic, one off the coast of Africa, 30% chance of developing there, 70% chance, and this one is expected to stay more into the central northern portion of the Atlantic. So both of these, at this point, do not look like a concern. It's the wave that's in the Caribbean right now that we're really going to talk about, and that's because it is going to trend towards the southernmost portion of the Gulf of Mexico by Saturday and into Sunday. At this point, it's really too early to tell you exactly the intensity and the track that it will take, but I'm going to walk you through what we know right now. Right now, we have high pressure on top of us. That's going to back off west. That's going to allow our temperatures by tomorrow and Friday to drop down just a little bit. We'll take that, right? High pressure builds off to the east. Both of these have clockwise flow. That's just the circulation pattern around an area of high pressure. So as this moisture source, or this wave, the cluster of thunderstorms that we're tracking right now, travels through the Gulf by Saturday into Sunday. This is as we get into Sunday morning. Where this exactly travels is still extremely uncertain because of these two areas. Does it pick up the upper level winds around this area of high pressure? Does it more pull towards this? And it also depends on how far west that backs off. I'll show you the latest trends. This is the GFS. If you were watching this yesterday afternoon, you may have noticed that the landfall was actually towards Matagorda Bay. And that would have put us really with the dirty side or the wet side. That's still a possibility. I mean, this has changed a lot overnight, and now this is trending really east. Big shift with the GFS if you're watching these model patterns. But that's the key. You need to watch consistency whenever you're looking at model patterns. Don't just look at one screen grab on Instagram or Facebook and think that's what's going to happen. You have to see consistency with these trends. And right now, these models really don't know exactly where this is expected to travel. This is Monday, 4 o'clock, and now Euro and the GFS are in agreement that it's expected to stay east of Houston. How east? Euro has it more of a Texas, Louisiana landfall. Remember that GFS I just showed you more was a Louisiana landfall. Time will tell. We're going to continue to monitor this. We may have a named storm by Friday or Saturday, and then we're going to start to get, hopefully, some agreeance again with these models and some consistency there. Today, watch out for this air quality alert, especially if you have asthma or if you have emphysema. That's the first thing you're going to notice. That's because we have calm winds. We're going to start off with lots of sunshine, and that added pollution will just make for those ozone levels a little bit higher. Heat advisories to our north and to our east. We're still, I mean, across the country, millions of people tracking this heat. This morning, it's a muggy start. 94 in Galveston is the feels like temperature. 91 at Hobby Airport. Sugarland this morning feeling like 85. So a sticky start to the day. Rain chances do pop in. That's really the biggest change for today. About a 40% chance this afternoon. High temps go to 97. Yesterday, we hit a high of 97, so we're pushing a repeat for today. And then take a look. These temperatures, though, start to inch down by Thursday, Friday, and through the weekend, back down to the mid to low 90s, and our rain chances remain. Steph, as we continue to watch these model trends with that wave, that's when we're going to know the intensity and the track. And that will change our rain chances, potentially, for the beginning of next week. I'll send it back to you.
Yeah, something to watch for sure. All right. Let's take you to the North Beltway on the westbound side, and it's the frontage lanes we're talking about. We have new activity that we're tracking for you. Apparently, two cars got into it here, so we've got a lot going on there at Ella. What you can do is, unless you work there at the gas station or you're trying to get gas, then you will be directly impacted by this. Stay on the main lanes if you can. Again, that is going westbound on the frontage lanes. Elsewhere, I am not watching too much. There's not much to worry about out there at all. And that includes the Katy Freeway. It is a solid and smooth drive from 99 all the way into downtown. Normally, we'd have a little bit of slowing by the Energy Corridor and Spring Branch at this time as you head.